Welcome back to the Leading Women series. I'm Space News correspondent Debra Werner. Today I have the pleasure of speaking with Shikha Ganguly, L3Harris Technologies Weather Solutions General Manager. Hi, Shikha.
Hi, Debra.
Will you please tell us what that means you're in charge of for L3Harris?
Sure. Like you said, I'm the general manager of weather at L3Harris. That's within our spectral solutions division in our space sector. So in my job, I'm responsible for programs that advance weather prediction capabilities by delivering best-in-class instruments, infrared sensing instruments, and ground systems to U.S. and international customers. So in practice, this involves staying on the forefront of core technology development, building high-trust customer relationships, and maintaining a highly capable team.
Great. Okay. From LinkedIn, it looks like you first worked at L3Harris through an internship program. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. This was a great internship program. I was fortunate to find it through my school's internship opportunity listings.
And so what made you join the company and stick with it?
Yeah, good question. So in this internship, I ended up having the opportunity to work on the James Webb Space Telescope program. I had really helpful mentors. And the other thing that I really liked about this experience was that I was given a project to do some real design work on a very small test feature on this telescope. So, of course, in the grand scheme of things, it was a tiny piece of a huge and massively complex project, but I felt really good about the idea of something that I had touched, potentially flying on such an important mission and being a part of this team working toward better understanding of our universe. It was kind of a taste of what I had gone into aerospace engineering for in the first place, which was about lasting impact on our understanding of our world.
And so what made you stay there for more than 15 years?
Yeah, great question. So the thing that's great about L3Harris is that at this one company, I've had an opportunity to serve a huge diversity of mission sets and customers in different locations, but there have been some really key constants for me at the same time. So every organization that I've worked in here has been, you know, generally full of people with strong and mission-focused values and really brilliant talent. So our value proposition at L3Harris is often about differentiated solutions, which really makes us a magnet for some of the best talent in the world. And I've also found that while this part isn't unique to us, I've really found that some of the smartest people have also been some of the most humble and caring people that I've come across. And, you know, working with people working alongside people like that has really been energizing and great. And I've been lucky to develop some long-lasting friendships that I've been able to carry through all of the different assignments and roles.
Great. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration is preparing for a new generation of weather satellites. Is that an important opportunity for your organization?
Yeah, absolutely. This is really a pivotal opportunity for our part of L3Harris. We've got in our business over six decades of heritage in developing weather sensing instruments and ground systems for NOAA and NASA. And this has prepared us really well to provide backbone capability to NOAA as they build these new architectures. So last year we won the GeoXO Imager instrument, which is an 18-channel high-resolution imager that builds on the success of the Advanced Baseline Imager that we built for the GOES-R series, which launched its last satellite earlier this week. Very exciting. And so building on that, GXI will add two new channels for enhanced water vapor measurement and therefore severe storm prediction. And it also improves the resolution of seven existing channels. So that also helps with severe storm prediction and also improves the really valuable fire detection capability that ABI brought about and allows us to now detect smaller fires, which is really helpful. we're also looking forward to the future as NOAA continues to recapitalize their major architectures and are looking forward to providing support to the space weather and NEON missions that are coming up.
Right. L3Harris also is involved in missile warning satellites, is helping build missile warning satellites for the Space Development Agency. Does the pace of SDA work present any specific challenges?
Yeah, absolutely. It's really brought about a lot of change and cultural change within our organization that has been valuable to us in different in our different endeavors. So this missile warning work for the Space Development Agency has taken work that's traditionally been measured in 5 to 10 year scales and compressed it down to closer to 3 years, which has presented a lot of challenges both internally and throughout the supply chain down to sub-tier suppliers. Really forces us to be more responsive, agile, and think differently about how to execute our missions. And so, you know, we've been successful in doing that and growing in that way of thinking. And that's really important because in this side of our business, we're driven by external adversaries. And so the pace is very different than what we've seen traditionally with our weather customers, but importantly so. So the always faster charter that we have over there drives us to new ways of thinking, which has really brought about some interesting challenges, but also some opportunities because while we have been challenged to grow in this way and hit more aggressive timelines and have done that, it's allowed us to find ways to streamline. And that's something that allows us to really bring opportunities to our other customers as well. It's interesting because the missile defense work that we've done built on that same foundation and same core technologies that we've used for weather for decades. And so there's a lot more commonality that you would think technology-wise, and we've just used it in some different ways here.
And that makes me think of the pace of technological change overall. It seems like we're experiencing such a rapid pace. What opportunities and challenges does that present?
Yeah, agree. It's a really exciting time in the aerospace industry with major changes coming to bear. We've got increased launch vehicle access, flexible software-based capabilities on our technologies, to name a couple of things. I think that some of these changes really enable us to bring home what parts of our industry have really aimed for and longed for decades. That's faster and more flexible solutions that we can iterate on more quickly than we ever could before. So this is really powerful for our customers with challenging mission timelines like our Space Development Agency customer, but like I said, also opens up interesting opportunities for our civil customers.
So that makes me think about your background. You earned a bachelor's degree in aerospace engineering and a master's in systems engineering from the University of Michigan. How well did those degrees prepare you for your current job?
Yeah, thanks for asking. These degrees did prepare me really well for my current job. I'll admit that I haven't touched an aerospace engineering equation for several years, but the analytical thinking that was really learned in my engineering education at the University of Michigan serves me really well in daily decision-making about business needs. I'll say also that my master's program there in particular was, I think, really unusually great preparation for success in industry, especially at the time. It was a little unusual in that it was a project-based program that put students into teams developing CubeSat payloads and ground systems. So it wasn't a thesis-based program. It was very much about doing what you would do in industry, which is form teams, have a mission, and go execute it. So I really have some unforgettable memories of at the culmination of that, driving around the Midwest on a chase team with a mobile antenna, tracking and retrieving a payload that our team launched on a weather balloon at the end of one of our semesters there, which was great. And I will say that the keys to success in that were the same ones that we live every day in industry. So it forced critical thinking, willingness to learn, and collaboration, which all go a long way.
Do you have advice for people entering this, the field, the space sector, who may not fit the stereotype that most people think of when they think aerospace engineer, which, I mean, the field remains overwhelmingly white and male. What advice do you have for somebody who's not?
Yeah, you know, I think I would say that early on, I internalized some of the maybe negative energy that came with that difference. And I think several folks have felt the pressure of an almost implied question that comes up sometimes, which is, given that you're different, sometimes folks will question why you are where you are, and if it has to do with your background or minority status versus just your capability. And that was something I was kind of sensitive to early on. And so there was almost a guard up because of that. I will say I'm happy to find that I at least don't think that that's quite as severe for the folks that I've seen come up in next generations. I think folks are a little bit more comfortable with their status and are able to tap into that a little bit. So what I would say is that what I learned over time is to really kind of embrace that difference and try to enable people who also have the same, and instead of maybe internalizing some of the negative energy that might come along with that, keep an eye on the bigger picture, which is that what we really want at the end of the day is for folks to be able to contribute regardless of background and not have that difference stand in their way or make them feel less part of a team. And so really just being connected and enabling each other to make sure that we get to that end state and actually putting that at the forefront rather than trying to bury it is what I'd encourage people to do.
Great. You've answered my questions. Is there anything else you wanted to say?
I think I'll just, like I mentioned, this has been an exciting time as we're coming off the launch of the GOES-U satellite, the last in the GOES-R series. So given that, I'll just reflect on, you know, the excitement of that moment. And it's one of those moments that causes you to step back and reflect on what a large and diverse team has really achieved across different companies, agencies, and it allows folks to come together at the end of a really long road and celebrate a massive achievement. So it was really nice to just reflect on that and just enjoy the community that forms around important missions like that and just see everybody really come together with the same goal. So it was a good reminder of why we're here.
Great. Well, thank you so much for talking with us.
Thanks.